My name is Dan Hood. I live in Knoxville, Tennessee, and I'm a printmaker. There's so many different ways to do art. I guess why I became an artist probably had to deal with, I don't know. I don't really have any other options. So I just was like, well, I couldn't go be like a math teacher or an English teacher or really even an art teacher. I just needed to make art. A lot of the work that I do has to deal with repurposing like urban objects and kind of mundane things that are kind of just like left on the side of the road. A lot of my work focuses on like light poles and light bulbs, a lot of like very large, like kind of phallic skyscraper-ish objects that we see all the time but aren't necessarily looking at, and kind of finding a way to repurpose them and turn them into art objects. Photolithography is something that I've really gotten into a lot lately. It's a really fun process. The art process, the making process, is one that doesn't really stop. You know, I mean, a piece in itself I see as more of a jumping off point, in a point where you can continue like progressing your art, than like, I guess, like a finalized object on a wall. I gravitate a lot towards any place that has a large concentration of construction equipment and abandoned properties. I just have a really big fascination for kind of things that have been kind of thrown aside and just kind of let rust. I have really big fascination for just kind of junkyards, basically. So some of the other places that I guess I hang out in Knoxville for kind of, I guess, like inspiration and for just kind of being around other like-minded people is probably the art building on campus, for sure. There's a bunch of people over here, but then we always end up kind of like going down to the yacht club on the strip and just like getting drinks and hanging out and talking about stuff. So it's fun, it's nice. I definitely plan on pursuing this for the foreseeable future.
I am Marta Lee. I grew up in Washington State and now I live in Knoxville, Tennessee. I wanted to become an artist because I grew up in a family of artists and I started drawing and painting at a very young age. Right now the work that I'm making is more focused on materials and literal touch and using materials that other people have touched, like gum that people have chewed or gum that I have chewed, or wrapping paper somebody gave me, tissue paper, just like things like that. And I'm doing that because I am just becoming more interested in materials. The work that I made earlier was really coded and like narrative based, but like based on a narrative that I didn't really tell the viewer. Like I would have a story behind it that would help me make all my formal decisions, but then I didn't really say like, this is purple because of this, even though in my head I would have like reasons for all these things. So the stuff I'm making now is less like contrived or coded and more just naturally developing content. It's hard to figure out when things are finished. Usually if I have any question of whether or not it's finished, I try to leave it alone. In 20 years, I would like to still be making work and hopefully financially supporting myself with my work. But if not, like probably doing some teaching. I'd like to live close to New York City or close to Chicago or one of those big art cities, if not like in one of them.
I'm Tory Legg, I'm 23 and I'm a jewelry designer based in Knoxville, Tennessee. I wanted to become an artist because, well, I didn't really choose to, I just sort of became that way. My mom is super artistic and creative and the genes passed down, so I was always interested in arts and crafts, all that kind of stuff. But the jewelry aspect started about 3 years ago. Right now I'm working on pretty much all sorts of jewelry. I'm mainly working with copper and a little bit in sterling, but copper I definitely like more because it goes with so many things. I'm kind of addicted to gemstones, and so many stones look really, really awesome with copper. And so that's my main focus right now, hammered stuff, soldered stuff. A lot of times I'll have an idea going into a piece, and then halfway through I go like a totally different route that ends up being way cooler, so that's always a really fun surprise. I see myself continuing to evolve and learn new skills and further my ability in jewelry making. And also, people always ask me if I want to have a store, which I don't really want to because I feel like that's too stationary. And I want to get to the point where I'm well known enough that people just want to carry my stuff so that I can be represented in all different parts of the country or wherever. And it would also be cool to be able to travel around and sort of do like trunk shows and just, you know, get to do what I love while also traveling, which I love, so that would be pretty awesome. But I love what I do, and the fact that other people like it is just sort of icing on the cake.